Guys, welcome to episode 30. This is the Portfolio Manager Code Essentials series. And today, what we're going to be doing is to modify the trading bot so that we can store at the trading engine, specifically the trading episode, the values of the episode base asset and episode quote asset. Okay? I'm talking about these guys here, to be able to have a value on them. So when we do this, we can see the value here and here. And also when this information goes to the portfolio manager, the base and quote asset are data that are available to the portfolio manager itself. Okay, so for this task, we were going to need this, the code of the trading bot. Okay, here we have the trading engine somewhere, or the trading episode. Okay. When we open the episode, is the right place to see if we can set up these values. Okay, so the values, we're going to take them, I don't know from where we have available these values. Let me check, how do we place the orders at the exchange? Chain config. Okay, here we have it. This symbol represents the base asset and the quote asset. Okay, so we will need these guys at the trading episode. And we are going to put comment here, set the value, the base, and quote the answer. Okay. So we have the episode here. So these nodes are called episode base asset, episode quote asset. Okay. Episode base asset. Episode base asset is going to be this value. An episode quote asset is going to be this other value. Okay, so that is going to give the value to these nodes. And probably it's enough for what we want, but we also want, when we activate these layers, I for example, current episode, we want to see those values while visually debugging. So in order to fix that, we're going to come here, trading episode, counter statistic, candle, balance distance, base asset, quote assets, current episode. Okay, this is the product that we need to add. These are the current values that we are recording, okay? If you check this out right here, you will see that we have serial number identifying begin race status, blah, blah, blah. Then process date, and we need these two that are not there. Okay, so we're going to use this as an example. Copy this, and we are going to add two more guys. Okay, so this is going to be episode base asset. And this is going to be episode voted asset. Okay. So if we go here, this is going to be episode base asset. And for this guy, episode quote asset. Okay, so only by doing that we are adding the two missing pieces of this puzzle. So we're closing all of you. We are going to generate a new version of this Trading Mind plugin. So we are going to come here, SuperIOS plugins, algorithmic trading, trading minds, and we are going to upgrade the current trading mind. Is the stuff that we need. So, next thing to do is to try this out. So we will refresh this. Okay, we will refresh this. I will also open another file explorer. SuperIOS platform, my data storage. I'm going to delete all the data so that to have a clean version of the execution of that strategy. Okay, so we're going to run this again. see if our changes work out. Okay, have that running. Run this. Okay, I think I have a time range of 2 days here. Yeah, that's because of a test I was doing, but it's okay. Now we can come here. We have this full execution of this strategy. So we're also going to go to the trading engine. Perfect. Look at this. Episode base asset BSDC and USDT. Okay. Oh, this is awesome. So we will create pull request. No, we are going to this is showing base and hold there trading engine. Okay, so this is done and working beautifully. Perfect. Okay. The next thing I want to do now is going to the portfolio manager code. Here. We will not need all this stuff now. So what I want now is, yesterday we've seen that here we have an array of the managed sessions, okay? But we need a way to enable for conditions and formulas at the portfolio manager to have access to the session parameters of the managed bots. Okay. So in order to do that, I believe that what we need is here. These are the session parameters session parameters of the portfolio bot. But we're going to have trading. Okay, can be manage session parameters. Okay, so how are we going to create this information or this array? So this is an array, right? That is pointing toward the sessions. Okay, so let's see here. Okay, we need to switch to here. This switch is for okay, so the trading bot will have an array of this session reference node, okay? And these have a reference to this kind of node, okay? Which have trading parameters. So, session reference have a reference parent. So, this is the reference parent, and these have trading parameters. Sorry. These got trading parameters. Okay. Trading parameters is equal to undefined, then it continues. And then we're going to do like this. Going to push this So in the end, we will have an array of each of the session parameters that we can use in the same way that we use this one, at conditional formulas. Okay. So we are going to make a test of this in here. First, we're going to debug this small code to make sure that everything is okay. Then we are going to make a test when we eval a condition null. Oh yes, when we eval the condition. Because we're going to set up a condition. That uses that object, okay? So let's go back here. Portfolio system, no, yes. Not a formula, but a condition. So we are going to write here manage session meters dot session what asset dot config dot initial balance. Okay. So that means that we are going to read this stuff and return it instead of true or whatever. So we are going to save this. And we are going to run this task from here. And we are going to link or run this from here. Debug mode, perfect. Okay, so you ran. Then we can run this without debugging, just here. And then we will run both sessions from here. Okay. Okay, this didn't work. I was experimenting a little bit with these new syntaxes. I'm going to do it in this traditional way. I always do this. That is like this. Okay, so we're going to try it again. I forgot this was an array. Okay. So I know this is the index 0 because I am the one who produced the list of managed sessions, right? So I'm supposed to be building this knowing the order in which I don't really like, but first iteration, let's say. let's run it again. Value is 1000, that is the initial value. Okay, so we have access to all the managed sessions, and that is exactly what we wanted to do at this episode. Okay, so because everything works up so well, we are going to extend the scope of the episode and move into the next task. The next task is, how do we, so here we're going to commit these changes, manage session parameters object available and formulas add profile manager. Okay, so say the value with the having access to manage trading parameter from condition formula done. Okay, the next problem we need to solve is the following. Today we can put conditions and formulas or rules, let's say confirm event reference. This would be like a rule. Okay, this is another rule. But these rules are pointing to specifically they are pointing to a trading system. So if you have more than one bot running with the same trading system, then it's not going to be unique. Okay, and it might happen that for whatever reason you might want to reuse the trading system. That means that we'll need a way to know which rule we have to apply and that depends on the specific managed bot that is asking me. Okay, so we need to partition all this, all this stuff by trading bot. So for trading bot number one, trading bot number one, I would have an event manager and formula manager. With all the events and stuff inside. The same for trading bot number two, number three. Or the other way to do it is to have one event manager and one formula manager. And we are going, when you're going to look for the specific rules, we do it per bot. So let's analyze this and see which solution is better. So let's say that I want to hook up the bots here. This has some similarity to this problem. Manage trading bot, manage trading bots. So I might have a node in here, set event rules, but then I will need a different node for each of this branch, because this, the node that goes here has to attach to this and have only these kind of children. Another possibility is that the portfolio system have a managed session here, or an array of managed sessions. And for each managed session, I have a formula manager on this, so I just move this into here. And the managed session can reference specifically the session that I am going to let go through this branch, and the session ID is something that I already have. Let me check this, what I have available. So the portfolio events manager receives the event. confirm this event. Why is this also defined here? Something is not correct. Okay. No, it's okay. But this is the actual caller. Okay, so the sequence is this portfolio system events manager. And formula manager. Okay, so we will need not a session key here. So who calls this guy? The events interface. So here we have the session ID, for instance. So I can add this here, for instance, and this will come into here. And this session ID, I can add it here. Here and here and here. Session ID, 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 ID. And this will come into here. Okay, but it's not here, it's here. And that means that we can send the same session ID here, 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 and here. Then confirm this event we have the session ID we have the session ID same thing with the formula And finally, okay, we got the session ID there. Now we need a change at the node structure at the UI. So I'm going to create a node that I'm going to place it here that is going to have as a child this and this. I'm going to be able to reference it any type of trading session. Okay. And yeah, that's what we need to do. So let's go here. We're going to call this guy. Manage session friends. So it will be quite clear that is a reference. Manage session reference. Okay. So we'll delete this. Delete this child. but its parent is going to be called manage session references, because it's going to be an array. The parent is going to be portfolio system. Okay. Okay, so the parent is going to be portfolio system. We are going to locate the parent soon. But the important thing is that we need to put this so this goes in here. Good. Then the portfolio system should know about this guy. I'm not sure how this user-defined code will work, but I know that these guys are going inside this guy, and I know that these two guys now are going to be children of these two guys. Okay, and that you will need an array of these guys with this here, and we will need a menu to add these guys. So this is the type of children. We will not need these two guys. Okay, manage session, this is going to work like this. Okay, probably it's going to work. So these two, event manager and formulas manager, are not going to be a child of another guy. Events manager and formulas manager. This is going to be their parent, actually. Okay. So I guess this should work. We will need an icon for this. So platform, no. Projects, portfolio management, icons. And the icon name, as always, is going to be this guy. Okay, so to test this, I'm going to disconnect this guy from here. Sorry, from here and from here. Save it. But there's something missing. The reference parent. We need the reference rules. And we need these to be able to attach to baby training session, forwarding session, to all these guys. Okay, now we have it all. We might be able to refresh this. So, manage session reference, Okay. It will read these two guys by default, which is not a bad idea. The only problem is that I already had these two guys here. So one here and the other here. Okay. So this session reference we are going to connect it to the only one that we can connect it. But the only thing that is missing is that the title okay, we're going to change it for this. That means that the name of this is going to be based on the guy that is referencing, okay? So we can refresh this and check the code. And the code, what we can do is actually probably when we initialize it, we can have a map. Off. Even manager's map, let's call it. Which we're going to say that this is equal to a new map. And what we're going to do is for let E So we're going to populate the map now. We're going to ignore the one that doesn't have a reference parent. And we're going to do events manager map. Dot set. The key is going to be the ID of the session, okay, of the session node, and the value is going to be this guy dot event manager. That is in fact this property events manager. Okay, and that's it. Once we have an ID here, we are going to say let event manager equal to event manager map dot get dot session ID, and that is the guy we are going to use. Okay, so if this case okay, so as easy as that. Then the same thing we're going to do it down here. And that's the way we are going to solve this problem. We are going to debug this guy and this, but exactly the same thing we're going to do it at the portfolio formula manager. Okay. Still, I need to delete this and replace it for formulas manager. So we're also going to debug this and one of these. Okay. So that's the code. So we have the automatic title of this. Okay. Okay. So let's debug it. We are going to run this guy. This can run directly in Node.js. And when both are running, we run both sessions. We hit the first breakpoint. Okay. Okay, I forgot to undefine the map on the finalize. I'm going to do it now. Okay. We don't have the reference parent because we didn't include them. In the information that is going to the task server. So we need this line of code. Here. Okay. And we will need also to undefine this map here. And this guy here. Okay. So let's run this. Run. You can also run. You both can run. Okay. Oh, why? Okay, the problem is that we didn't refresh this page in order to take the changes that we made at that function. Okay, so now we're back here. So first debug here, and then we run this guy. Then we run both. Okay, let's go again. This and this. This reference now is existing. That means that this map will have one element here. And it's going to be this event manager. So this is okay. The same with the formula. So this is great. Perfect. What is this? Okay, so as far as I can see, all these changes worked. So we are kind of done. Okay, so to recap, what we have done is to first, we save the value of the quote and base asset at the portfolio, at the trading engine. Then we enable having access to the managed trading parameters from condition formulas. And third, we manage, we added this new node, manage session reference, to the portfolio system so that each trading bot has its own set of, has its own events manager and formula manager with its own set of rules that you can customize for that specific bot. Okay? So now I think this is much more complete and everything seems to be working. So this is all for now. Thank you for watching and see you next time.